What's up guys, welcome back for another Yu-Gi-Oh! Pro Duel video next match, Cross Balanced Cup. So, underway here in the top 16, cut off again, one deck, or at least each deck is allowed to lose once, but then if it loses, if any particular deck loses its match, it will move on to the left side of the bracket here. If it wins, speaks for itself to the right side. First deck list, we have a Synchrocat. Synchrocat from 2008, by the way, not 2009, since this is an OCG list with, you know, Brionek, Pre-Errata. Again, you can use it multiple times during the same turn. Royal Oppression was still legal. Crush card, you know, having access to crush card, right? Multiple Bottomless, multiple Cold Wave again, multiple Dark Arms. Not really sure that was able in a TCG, although you might have, at least you might have had access to two, I guess. Anyway, the one of Pot of Errors in the main deck, but again, main core, the main strategy of this deck is to fully rely on abusing Premature Burial and of course your Hidden Armory again, thanks to your Brionek, by keep bouncing back your Premature Burial that's equipped to, well, again, preferably Reborn Rescue Cat, right? The second deck list, we have Blue Eyes again, one of the more recent decks in the Cross Balanced Cup. This should be Shunsuke Hiyama's winning Worlds list with only one emptiness, but again, that card is like a game stealer, same for Royal Oppression indeed. Multiple hand traps again can be quite important, especially again pre, at least post priority, so both Maxi and effect failure can definitely be very crucial here in this particular matchup. So which deck has the advantage? A lot of people, as you see here, again, preferred the more recent deck, and that's Blue Eyes for multiple reasons. I mean, having access to both Wing Blast, Emptiness, the whole Blue Eyes engine, right? Again, Power Creep, the Hand Traps, as I mentioned before. But I think the most important thing here is, of course, the main deck Twin Twister, but the Blue Eye Synchro, level 9 Synchro, prevents, you know, prevents your opponent from special summoning more than two, or at least two or more monsters during the same time, so it pretty much stops your Rescue Cat if the Blue Eyes Synchro is on the field. So again, that's a huge, huge powerhouse against a deck like, you know, Synchro Cat. Okay, so let's hop in into the first duel. So the first duel, starting definitely with Synchrocat, going first, desetting, such an old school move, but setting the Raikou and setting the Bottomless was definitely an okay move for the time. The Decrow definitely comes in clutch here, I believe banishing the White Spirit Dragon, it's White Spirit, right? And then immediately flipping over the Raikou for the plus one, so important here, getting rid of the one of Backrow, right? Keeping the Storm for potential later plays, although, you know, Blue Eyes doesn't really run too many Backrows, I guess. Another potential play. Maybe that was a bit better, instead of going for the second Arabellum, just go for Dark Panther, you know, what, or at least which monster is Blue Eyes going to set, right? He definitely uses, I think, the last search for the White Stone, so now in the end phase he doesn't have another Blue Eyes left to special summon it from the deck, right, with the other stone. But then again, I could have gone for game 10 if he only had one Blue Eyes on the field. Same situation here, different scenario with him, setting one Backrow, but again, I still had the Heavy Storm set, so special summoning the Cyber Dragon, and then, you know, this, ladies and gentlemen, this is why Brain Control is banned, or, you know, was banned pre-Errata, by the way, since, as you know, Brain Control got the Errata, and now it's pretty much not that great anymore, pretty much irrelevant, right? But again, Brain Control was banned because of this, it's stealing games, I guess. He does use a White Spirit effect, that's definitely okay, but he doesn't have, like, a target, right? Then again, the top deck of Twin Twister is definitely super solid, since that, at the same time, Twin Twister during the draw or standby phase immediately gets a Blue Eyes, a regular Blue Eyes from his hand to the graveyard to potentially be reborn by Azure Eyes. But as you know, Royal Oppression does negate the effect of Azure Eyes, but won't destroy it due to its effect. So I'm definitely behind, and this is definitely a very good move on his part of special, at least tribute summoning the White Spirit, I believe. And yeah, one of those alternatives already use its effect, so just go for the Exceed. And you know, that then a Galaxy just like more than enough attack to attack for a game. So 1-1, again, I get to start. And this is something I forgot to mention, is that starting from the top top 16. And it's something that viewers already mentioned, is that from now on, a deck post starting, you know, 2014 or later, with the, you know, implementation of Konami implementing the new opening rule of only drawing 5 cards. If a deck post 2014 starts, it will only get the 5 cards. But again, the older decks will still have that 6th card, since I think, you know, the newer decks are just made and, you know, card design, etc., based on that new opening rule. Again, only decks, only for decks post 2014. So I purposely waited until the top 16 to start with this, but I think that's the fairest way, right? Earlier, I sacrificed my rescue cat to go for double Arbalum, didn't take any chance, you know, just discard my opponent's two cards in his hand. Okay, I'm not ending with like a monster on the field, potentially like Goyo or Brionex, since, you know, one of his cards in his hand could have been like an alternative, and a potential top deck of Blue Eyes, of maybe he has like a White Stone in his grave. I don't think so, since, you know, he would have used it here with a trade-in, but okay, anyway, now I'm in a good position, top decking the Summoner Monk. Just set it. Normally Monk cannot be tributed, I think. Yep, indeed, so just set it, and face down, Crush card can still be activated. That gives me 3 Darks in the graveyard, and one of those spells, Heavy Storm, Mystical Space Typhoon, Giant Tornado, are those cards to get rid of the Royal Oppression. And again, one of those key cards being Oppression, the second Oppression, I guess, definitely sealed the deal here in game number 3, and that was also important during the previous games, but okay, this was definitely a good tool. Unexpected, since, as I think everyone also thought, I thought Blue Eyes would definitely have the advantage and would probably win this matchup. But again, as it proves, at least, yeah, proved multiple times before in the Cross Balanced Cup series, is those older cards like Pre-Errata Crush card, Royal Oppression, Brain Control Pre-Errata, you know, Heavy Storm as well, those Seki cards, they are just so, so powerful, right? And again, Royal Oppression was just too good here in this particular matchup. So Cat, Synchro Cat will move on to the top 8, to the right side of the bracket, and you know, Blue Eyes is still in the tournament, pretty much will move on to the left side of the bracket. The next matchup, let me double check, this should be, I think, the more, or at least one of the more interesting ones. The next matchup will be Monarchs versus Chronomaly, so the second match here from the top. Again, like always, feel free to leave your predictions. Okay, guys, that's it. Thanks for watching, and feel free to leave a comment or a like if you enjoyed the video. Leetum signing out. Peace.